Today, I want to tell you a secret about vitamin C. Hello and welcome. All right. So today we're going to talk about vitamin C. And you know, vitamin C is probably the most well-known vitamin of all time. I mean, it's a popular one. It's got a lot of studies out there on it, a lot of information on it. It's just known that it can do all kinds of great things. It helps cut the risk of getting a common cold up to like by half. It can reduce the duration of the cold if you get it. And in fact, up to like 15%. And we know that vitamin C lowers your risk of some diseases. And it even helps clean the arteries. So it does have a lot of great benefits. And that's why most people take vitamin C on a regular basis. But did you know that there's a difference to the types of vitamin C? Now, if you look at your bottle, if you take out your bottle of vitamin C out of the cabinet, you turn it around, look at the ingredients, usually if you read that, it'll say ascorbic acid. And that's what most people are taking. And ascorbic acid is vitamin C, right? Well, here's the thing. If you look at other bottles of vitamin C and you turn to those ingredients, you may see ingredients like acerola cherry, oranges, even berries could be on there. And it's like, wait a second, what's the difference here between these two? Yeah, one of them sounds like it's made from real stuff. And what is ascorbic acid? So ascorbic acid, when it's on the bottle by itself there, that is synthetic vitamin C, meaning it's man-made in a laboratory. So, you know, what does it take to make this ascorbic acid? Because the Whole Foods one is actually made out of the acerola cherry or the oranges or the berries. It's actually made from the real thing. So, you know, why can't I just take the synthetic? What's the problem with that? Because it's usually less expensive anyway. So here's the ingredients of ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid is made from really two things. And it's about a 15-step process to make it. It's made of corn syrup, high fructose corn syrup. Yeah, corn syrup, not that great for you. Really not good at all for you. It has really no benefit whatsoever. And then also the other ingredient it has, hydrochloric acid. So they put these two things together in the laboratory. And now you have, well, again, you got to go through that process. And now you have ascorbic acid, and this is sold as legitimate vitamin C. Now, there's a little bit of a problem here, because when you take a look at vitamin C and you get all these benefits for the immune system and all the other things that it does, it's really because real vitamin C, Whole Foods vitamin C, is composed of really four main things. It does have ascorbic acid in it, but it's a real ascorbic acid. But really, that's only about 5% of vitamin C. That 5% is really an antioxidant wrapper for the vitamin C. It really doesn't have the benefits. It's the other factors that are beneficial in the vitamin C, which is kind of scary, because if that's all you're taking, what's going on here? What am I being sold? So vitamin C actually not only has that 5%, around 5% ascorbic acid, it also has bioflavonoids in it. Bioflavonoids, yeah, you can even buy those by themselves in their own bottle. Great stuff. And also it has another thing, which not a lot of people have heard of, called J and K factor. And these two factors actually have some different functions, but they're fantastic functions for your health. And then also it has another ingredient in it called rutin. And rutin also fantastic for your health. Now, when we take vitamin C, it actually, when it's the real vitamin C and it has all these factors in it, not only does our body use it, but it stores some of it. And where it mainly stores a lot of it is in collagen tissue. And that actually helps keep the collagen tissue healthy also with a lot of these factors. So very important. Now, what happens when you just take ascorbic acid? Well, number one, you take ascorbic acid and your body's like, what the heck do I do with this? In fact, it's number two, it's kind of pro-inflammatory. So you may get an immune response with it, but you're actually triggering your immune system. You're triggering a negative response, which A negative response will usually be followed by a healing process, or you're triggering your immune system, which, yeah, that may help if you're trying to fight something and you've got maybe a lowered immune system. But the thing is, too, is in order for your body to utilize that synthetic ascorbic acid, it's got to say, hey, I need the other ingredients to make this work. So then it goes in and dips into your collagen and steals it out of your collagen. So people who are really low in vitamin C, all the ingredients of vitamin C, or they're just taking a boatload of ascorbic acid every day, they're pulling all of these ingredients out of their collagen, which, what can that do? Increase wrinkles, increase all kinds of other low collagen problems in the body. So another negative effect of ascorbic acid. In fact, there's a lot of studies out there on vitamin C, and some of them are negative. Some of them are like, yeah, if you take too much vitamin C, it can cause this problem. If you get too much vitamin C at high dose, it can start to cause this problem. The interesting thing about all those studies, they're done with ascorbic acid. They weren't done with real vitamin C. But on the title, it's labeled vitamin C because they're allowed to do that. So very interesting stuff when it comes to vitamin C. And, you know, really where vitamin C came into play was back in, I don't know, it may have been before the 1800s, when the people were getting diagnosed with scurvy. You know, they would go on these long ship journeys across the oceans, and they ran out of fruit. And so, again, they would start to get these symptoms of scurvy. And, still, people today that are extremely deficient in vitamin C can get these scurvy symptoms. And, you just don't hear about it a lot. But if you have bleeding gums, if your wounds are really slow to heal, softening of bones, loose teeth, ulcerations in your mouth or your gut, and then just kind of general weight loss and fatigue, these are signs of scurvy. Now, it's interesting because even back in, 1930s, the late 1930s, the guy that discovered ascorbic acid, he basically went to a person who had scurvy and said, here, let's try this. Didn't help him at all. The ascorbic acid did not help with scurvy whatsoever. Then they were finally like, well, give him some fruit. Fruit cleared it up right away. So again, there's these variations. So if you're taking ascorbic acid, you may want to think twice about that. And you could be making yourself worse because there are a lot of negatives to it. So do find a whole foods vitamin C. Definitely don't get scurvy in your life and reap the benefits of a whole foods vitamin C supplement. All right. Hopefully everybody got some great information out of this. God bless. And I'll see you on the next video.